Okay, we started about 4 minutes, but as I said, be carrying on from where you last left the practical. So the main purpose really is to finish the practical questions either from this week or last week. So trying to complete practical questions from question four, which is on the shared screen, and also practical three, which is also up just now on the shared screen. Okay, I leave practical four up. You can use Canvas to get the other practicals up. But the main purpose is to really kind of finish off the practicals. So for that, you need to have Racket open, so Dr. Racket open as well. Okay, so today's session is to finish off the practical sessions you were doing earlier this week. So, because this tutorial three, I think I had you before, earlier Monday. So, basically, the main things to begin with to finish practical four, and also if you haven't quite finished practical three yet, also to finish practical three. Please, use Canvas to get the whole practical three. I put practical four on the shared screen. If you still need to finish practical three, you can look at the Canvas. Please feel free to ask for any help in the questions, or as usual, try and go through some answers to go forward as well. But it does help if you let me know what practical you're on and roughly where you got up to as well. Okay. So please carry on from where you were before on Monday. So before, make sure you're carrying on practical from before, and please put in the chat what practical you're on and what question you're on, because it does help me as well. Okay, so if you are on question 5 and 6, here's my version of it. So question 5, just learn how to use conditional. So it's saying A is equal to 1, B is equal to 2, C is equal to 1, D is equal to 1. So if A is equal to B, so 1 equal to 2, you get output 1. If A is equal to C, so 1 is equal to 1, in output 2, which we see here, and if A is equal to D, we can output 3, so if 1 is equal to 1. However, this gets it here first, so it outputs 2, because remember, the last thing in the code, the function code in that aspect, is going to be outputted from that. Okay, in the functional language. They were saying A is equal to 32. And we are saying if A is equal to 13, it's an unlucky number. If 99, it's a lucky number. And if it's not that, there's nothing special about this number, which is what's been output here. For question 6, it's to find a function that extracts the third element from a list. So here I'm defining the function third element. So I'm going to output CADDR of X and then call it. So here's my list here, 1, 3, 5, 7. So I'm going to, this outputs third element. So if I go back to the first bit of the code using the conditionals, this is a bit like a switch statement in Java, C++. We're saying if A is equal to B, we can output 1. If A is equal to C, we would do this bit of the code, but we can output 2 because the last thing inside these rounded brackets is what's going to be outputted from that. If A is equal to D, we can output 3, but if really gone through this one, this would be terminated. Okay, so a bit like an if else if type statement. Then we said A is equal to 32. Then we're saying if A is equal to 13, so equals A 13, is an unlucky number. Okay, so leave that for about another half a minute before I put the questions back on. You can always look at Canvas as well for the questions. Okay, so I'm going to put the questions back up on the shared screen. So the next question is to define a function to create a palindrome. So for this, you might want to combine reverse and append, possibly sort as well, just to double check that they are sorted. You don't need to do that. Okay, so questions 7 is to create a function to create a palindrome from a given list, and then 8 is to check whether a list is a palindrome. So for these, might these again a combination of functions you've done before? Okay, so I'm going to, in a few, about a minute or so, I'm going to put the answers for questions 7 and 8 on the screen. But as always, work at your own pace, okay? So if you're ahead, don't worry, or if you're slightly behind, don't worry. Okay, so for question 6 and 7, sorry, and 8, 6 is to find third element. As you can see here, this here is creating a palindrome and then testing it. And then here, to find a function to test a palindrome. And again, I'm testing it for a list which is not a palindrome, and then a list which is a palindrome. And as you can see, it returns true and false. So leave the screen up for about a couple of minutes as usual for you to check or to help you if you're getting stuck. Okay, so the tutorial session's finished now, but I'll stay around for another 5 minutes in case you've got any last minute questions to give me, but otherwise you feel free to go. Okay, I'm going to hang on for just about 1 or 2 more minutes. If you have any last minute questions, but otherwise you are, feel free to go. Thank you.